Good afternoon, dear children. How are you all? Yes, I know. As usual, you are very excellent and safe at home. Today, we will see writing skill. And in that writing skill, we'll see precise writing. What is meant by precise writing? Precise writing, that is the definition. A precise is a summary. Precise is a summary of a passage or a text. You know, means that you will get one big passage, two paragraph, three paragraph passage you will get. That the big passage you will get, that you have to shorten that paragraph. That is called a precise writing. What is the definition of that? A precise is a summary of a passage. Summary, short summary. You know, when we explain the lesson, before detailed explanation, we always tell summary of the lesson. Means when we come to know the summary, we get the whole idea of that lesson. So the same thing is, when whole paragraph, two, three paragraphs are there, text is there, passage is there, you have to try to understand that passage, what is written, and make that shorten. That is called a precise writing. A precise is a summary of a passage or a text. It is a selection of the main points or ideas from a passage which are then written as few words as possible. Okay, means once again I'll tell you, you will get one long passage. That long passage you have to read and take out the main points from that, and you have to write short summary of that whole passage, whole text which you got. Okay, then what is the points to remember in that? What is the points in that? Remember to point. See, the first thing that while writing precise writing, you have to keep in mind that read that passage very thoroughly. Thoroughly in the sense, very carefully. Once you read, twice you read. Once we'll not get a complete idea of that passage. So read twice. Once you get your reading second time, you will get, you know, an idea, the complete idea of that. Some children may take three times, no problem, doesn't matter, you take three times, read three times. What I mean to say, you have to read that passage very carefully, very thoroughly, try to understand. And when you are reading, you take pencil also in your hand, whichever points you feel is very important, just underline with that, with pencil. Okay, so the first is read the paragraph thoroughly, that is very clearly, very carefully. What is the second point? Take the required points. Either you underline the required main points, the important points. What is precise writing? When you are taking the reading the big paragraph, that you have to shorten that paragraph, and जो भी paragraph के अंदर हम लोग पढ़ते हैं वो पूरा के पूरा वो summary में आना चाहिए. You should not leave even important points from that text passage which you got. Okay, that is very important. So take the required points from that passage or underline. You can write also in other page, or you can underline, yes, this is important when I have to write the precise, when I have to shorten that paragraph. Write in your own language. Here, don't pick up the sentences from the passage and write. No, you know, direct, indirect speech, you have to, when we go, that is reported speech, when we are talking like this, accordingly that, you have to write in the reported speech. You have to write in your own language. You don't use the as it is sentences and pick out and write in the summer precise writing. No. You can write in your own language, that is called the shorthand. Try to understand that paragraph and then you write in your own language. What is their thought? It must have a title. Precise writing must have a title. It carries marks. Precise writing must have title. It carries mark. It must be one third of passage. If you got the passage, 2-3 paragraph, 1/3 of. Now, for example, in whole paragraph, suppose now here we are taking one from your grammar book. From your grammar book, we are taking from 125 page number, they have given the passage. Okay, one passage they have given. For example, though that passage contain 150 or 152 words. Okay, 150 to 152 words. So you have to shorten that 150 to 150 words in 1/3. 1/3 means near about 50 words. Near about 50 words. That is very, don't extend your paragraph. And in that 50 words, that summary, whole summary must come in that. So this is the main important points while writing essay writing. When you write the essay writing, you must keep in mind all these points. That is, read the passage thoroughly, that is very carefully, once, twice, that's, it's up to you. Try to understand passage, what they want to say you. Okay, when you are reading the passage, you must understand what title I have to do, because title is also very important. Where they have given the main stress, accordingly you have to write your title. Okay, write in your own language. Don't pick up the as it is sentence from the passage and write in. No, you can write in your own language. Okay, it must have a title. It must have a title. It must be 1/3 of a passage. It must be 1/3 of passage. Suppose that passage is 150 or 152 words, that is 1/3 of that means that carries 50 words. Okay, see, this is and which paragraph they have given here in your 125, we'll read that paragraph, that we will see, and there only you also keep this page textbook before you open 125, and once I am reading, and then we'll see. Once I read very carefully, very slowly, try to understand this passage and which point I have written, so then we'll write essay writing. What is, let me read, and while I am reading, please dear children, pay attention very carefully. Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi was the youngest of four children in his family. His mother Putli Bai was an intelligent and sensible woman. Mohandas loved and respected her very much. Putli Bai was deeply religious. She practiced the religious practices she had imbibed from her elders with complete faith and dedication. She prayed before every meal and went to the temple every day. She fasted for several days. She believed that fasting helped in developing her strong willpower to resist temptation. Putli Bai raised her children strictly and made sure that they followed all that she believed in. When Mohandas was 7 years old, his father Karamchand Gandhi got a new job in Rajkot. When he was 7 years old, when he was very small, like you dear children, younger than you. Now I think so you are in 10 to 11 years old, younger than you. Okay, means first or second standard. Rajkot, and moved out of Porbandar. Mohandas was one of the best students in his new school. He liked to reach school early. So he used to eat the leftovers from dinner in breakfast was not leftovers from dinner if breakfast was not ready. He was frightened of ghosts, robbers and snakes like any other small town boy. Because of his fears, he wanted a light on in his bedroom all night. He was afraid of going out anywhere in dark. Okay. And Putli Bai had instilled a great sense of honesty in her children. Mohandas did not like the idea of telling lies to his mother. He was always very honest. Sudden exposure to boys from other culture made him question his existing beliefs. When Mohandas completed class 5, he went to Alfred High School. It was an English medium high school. There he had an opportunity to meet boys from different communities and religions. This school was the place which taught Mohandas how important it was for people from different religious background to live together in harmony. Now we will see the paragraph. Now we'll see, just now we read a paragraph, and in that paragraph we come to know that they have written about his family, and especially when he was childhood, 7 years old that time. Okay, so which points we have underlined, or which point we have taken out when we read the passage? Okay, see here. First paragraph. What is, how many paragraphs are there? Just now we read the paragraph 1, 2, 3 paragraphs are there, right? I think so. 3 paragraphs are there. Okay, so in that paragraph, this is first paragraph, this is second paragraph, I think so. This is third paragraph, and I think so. Fourth paragraph. Okay, so what we have seen, what we read, so we have taken out the important points from that. That is, in the first paragraph they have written about Gandhiji's, Mohandas, mother. So what point is that? Putli Bai was an intelligent, sensible and religious woman. Okay, that is, the main point is in the first paragraph. What is there in the second paragraph? Second paragraph, Gandhiji's life as a young boy in Rajkot. We have read that when he was 7 years old, they shifted, his parents shifted to Rajkot in Gujarat only. Okay, Rajkot. So that they have given in the second paragraph, Gandhiji's life as a young boy in Rajkot. What about the third paragraph? What they have given in the third paragraph? In the third paragraph, they have given the main point we have taken out, that is, importance of honesty taught to Gandhiji by his mother. Importance of honesty taught to Gandhiji by his mother. That we have seen the important point in the third paragraph. What is there in the last paragraph, that is in the fourth paragraph? Fourth paragraph, interaction with boys. When he went there and he had changed the school, he went to Alfred school. Okay, that community is different. So it is written there. So we have taken out this paragraph, interaction with boys of other communities taught Gandhiji the importance of living in harmony. Living in harmony in the different culture, in different communities, people. So these are the four important points we have taken out from that passage. Okay, now, so see, this is four paragraphs are there, near about 100 or 150. Okay, means I have not counted. So one third of passage we have to write. That is near about 50 words that presses. And whatever we have written, that summary must come. Jo bhi kuch humne wo paragraph mein read kiya hai, wo paragraph ka pura kya kehte usse story, wo one third paragraph mein aana chahiye jo hum log likhne ja rahe hain. Usme se koi bhi point eliminate nahi hona chahiye, koi bhi point miss nahi hona chahiye. So that now we are writing. So I have written here from that four paragraph. This I have written, I will read for you. What was that? The first was there, Putli Bai was an intelligent and sensible religious woman. The first paragraph, in the first paragraph, we have seen this. So what we have written there? See, and the title is very important. When we read that the whole paragraph, we come to know that they have written completely about their his childhood. So title we have written Mahatma Gandhiji's childhood. That is title. Title carries marks. So you have to keep in mind. Okay. So what is the first paragraph they have given about the Putli Bai, Mrs. Mother? Okay. So Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi was the youngest. Youngest means सबसे छोटा. सारे भाई बहनों में सबसे छोटा. Okay. So Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi was the youngest son of Putli Bai. Of Putli Bai. She was an intelligent. This point we have taken out, that must written honge. Okay, she was an intelligent, sensible and deeply religious lady. She was deeply religious really. She used to fast also. She used to go every day and she thinks that if we get the temptation. So don't write all that thing. The main thing is that, the main point is there that we have written that the deeply religious lady. See. So that, okay, then she raised all her children strictly, making sure they imbibed all the beliefs she had, whatever she used to do. So that she taught everything. So within one or two lines we have written, what is that? See, she raised all her children strictly, making sure they imbibed all the beliefs she had. She taught everything. Then what is that? When Mohandas was 7 years old, his family moved to Rajkot, that is other place. So moved to Rajkot. He enjoyed school there and was a brilliant student, and like a small boy. He too was scared. See here, the main important points I have written. So this paragraph is continued here. Okay, so what was there? Like a small boy, he too was scared of ghosts, robbers, snakes and dog. Putli Bai, what is the interesting here? Gandhiji's Rajkot life. We have written about the Rajkot life. Now, the importance of honesty taught to Gandhiji by his mother. What is that? See here. Putli Bai taught Mohandas the importance of being honest. You also be honest, dear children. Honesty pays us. Honesty is the best policy. So that his mother taught him. Okay, and he carried that till his death. Okay, the last breath of his life. Okay, now we come to that the fourth point we had taken out, that is importance of honesty taught to Gandhiji by his mother. So, Putli Bai taught Mohandas the importance of being honest. He questioned his own beliefs when he meet boys from other culture. Because he had changed his school, so he went in other school. There he see from the when he met boys from other culture, in interaction with other communities taught him the importance of living in harmony. See, the very big passage, we have shortened that passage and all the story has we have covered in one, that is called the Prasya writing. That is called shorten the paragraph. Small karne ka paragraph, near about 50 words. Don't take out the points from the passage and write as usual. You must write that essay in your own language. Title is also very important. And must see that it should not go beyond 50, 52 or 53 last. Means according to the passage. If the passage is very lengthy, you can go. But one third of, if that carries, as said that, divided by 3. If number of passages of 100, 150 words are there, divided by 3, we get the, near about 50. So 2, 3, 4 words here and there, it's okay. But try to write in your own language. Once again, I repeat, Essay writing, the full paragraph, the big paragraph, you have to shorten, write the summary in your own language, and title must be given. Here, dear children, I hope you understood the essay writing, how to write. In our textbook also, they have given on page number 126, 127, read those essays, try to understand that, and try to write with your own. Thank you and have a nice day.